You complain about us being divided, and then you immediately start using Chinese government communist propaganda talking points to attack our commander-in-chief amidst, according to your own definition, a pandemic. Who has the Americans' best interests at heart? What do we think about just taking a Corona pact where we all lick a popsicle stick?
I'm in. Yes, I think get it over with.
We're going to get it.
Let's get it.
Yeah. There's
get
no
it.
Way to
isolate,
not get it.
Get immunity, and you're free.
And I'm just hoping that or I'm dead. Like, you know, Tom or Hanks dead. And his wife, or Justin Trudeau's wife, and Idris yeah. Elba, or any of the NBA or NFL players, and that I get it, and I have no symptoms.
There you go.
Yeah, totally exactly. Fine.
Wait, is this a ploy for you guys to actually
Has there
kill
been
me?
Any public no. figure who has gotten it and had severe symptoms?
Not that I know
that
of.
I know of, yeah.
I don't think you're going to hear about it.
Yeah.
Oh, you just don't think they'll say so?
I don't think they want to say it. I mean, they may say it later. I bet you'll hear someone who was like, oh, you know, I had it. It was pretty bad. I just didn't want to let anyone
freaking
know about
scare
it.
Scare people?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because especially I would think it's at higher levels of government, they're going to do their best not to say anything.
Right.
Right.
It's going to create a panic.
Yeah. You mean more so than already?
Wait, are we talking about the, yeah. talking about
the
American
this
government?
Is a panic now.
In general. Ooh,
give it 30 days. It's going to get...
Who
wild.
Is your source? Because we all saw that morning, Half Asian Bill said, hey, by the way, Donald Trump's going to declare a national emergency
yeah,
at 2 o'clock
yeah.
today. He told me to go get gas, and I did, and you were off by 12 minutes.
Yes, I was. Ah, I was. It was a little delayed.
How did you know that?
You know things. You hear things.
We have a full Thursday show worked up for you, yeah. but wanting to do my part, I will have my personal doctor, Dr. Choi, on the show tomorrow,
yeah.
which is great because he is Asian, he's Korean, he's very funny, and he's very knowledgeable. He's on the American Board of Endocrinology, and he's been he's out there in Vegas where they just had, unfortunately, the first death, and now it's been sort of spreading. Yeah. And I think he's a good voice right now, a good voice of reason out there in the wilderness, because he's a very... Yeah. level-headed doctor. I like him a lot. He uses experimental methods. Like he's really kind of at the cusp of stem cells. But if you go in, he'll say, listen, this is what it maybe works for. He'll say, this is what it maybe work for. And not that. So some people's like, help. Like he goes, I swear to you. I go, does stem cells really help? He goes, well, approved in Europe for like acute joint. But some people, they say, you take stem cell, help everything. But look, I break my knee. I tear my ACL. Okay, year and a half, can't walk. Then 4 weeks stem cell. You tell me. We have to talk about Corona. There's nothing else we can talk about.
You have to.
And there are a wide range. I should say there are. I shouldn't start it off improperly. There's a wide range of opinions on the coronavirus. Okay, some people think that the quarantines, the closures are overkill, or we're shutting down too much of the economy. Others think we're not doing enough, that there can be no overreacting. Where do you line up? And right now, the blame game is going around. A lot of people blaming President Trump. Yeah. Some people blaming the media. China. Chinese government. Full stop.
Yep.
Donald Trump, don't trust China. China is asshole.
True words were never spoken.
Right from the start.
My cousin Wang, what a guy. He's amazing. Look at him. What a national hero.
He's famous.
Here's something. I understand this is a time where hopefully we can come together as Americans just to try and do the right thing. We need to protect those who are vulnerable. And really, that's older people, people with pre-existing conditions.
Yep.
Most young people who are healthy, you're probably going to get it. It's not going to be that severe. That's what we know thus far, but it could change. Yeah. Here's what really bothers me. I'll tell you this. Let's say Donald Trump had done everything wrong. Okay?
Right.
And let me clarify this too. I'm not going to be shamed into panicking. This is something else too. People get mad if you don't panic. Nope.
Yeah.
That's not going to happen. I'm going to react as genuinely as humanly possible. Let's assume that Donald Trump did everything wrong. Don't think that's the case, but let's assume that. I still don't like the media carrying the water of the Chinese government's propaganda, which is what we're seeing right now. I don't care if it was Barack Obama, Jimmy Carter, Bill Clinton. Nope. Sorry. That's my president. That's communist China. My team, your team. End of story.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's cut and dry.
So as the Wuhan virus right now, it's spreading beyond China. We've seen a huge shift, too, in how the media is covering it. So this is something a lot of people need to remember. They're trying to say now, oh, the right wing, they were saying, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
No. It wasn't a left-right thing. Look at BuzzFeed. Look at New York Times right here. They were the ones saying that it wasn't much to worry about. It was them. It was nowhere else, less than the common cold. But then they pivoted, now that it serves their interest, to try and blame Donald Trump for this pandemic. And that's also why people don't believe you. We'll come back to that. You know, there is value in times like these where people should hopefully be able to trust the media. But when you say it's not a big deal, don't worry about it, and then you only say it's a big deal because it's Donald Trump's fault, of course people don't believe the same folks who said Russiagate and f***ing prostitutes on furniture. Yeah. We don't believe you, and you have done the public a disservice. So let's start along the trail here to kind of go through it. This has kind of started with the virtue signaling that we've seen of reporters, late night hosts. All of a sudden now, you've seen this, they're saying that it is racist to refer to the coronavirus, COVID-19, for those in the medical know, as the Wuhan virus.
Tying coronavirus to China and Chinese people isn't just a racist dog whistle. It's a whole racist orchestra. It's a mighty, mighty racist boss tone.
China and others have criticized you for using the phrase
You like the mighty, mighty boss tone
virus. How do you feel about that? Are you going to continue using that phrase?
I have to call it where it came from. It did come from China. So I think it's a very accurate term.
No, it's not. It's a very racist term.
How? Keep calling this the Chinese virus. There are reports of dozens of incidents of bias against Chinese Americans in this country.
Dozens.
Your own aide, Secretary Azar, says he does not use this term. He says ethnicity does not cause the virus. Why do you keep using this? A lot of people say it's racist.
It's not racist at all, no. Not at all.
I love it.
It's from China.
China.
It's from China. I want to be accurate. Yeah, please, John.
China. There's AIDS behind you. Are you comfortable?
I have great love for all of the people from our country. But as you know, China tried to say at one point, maybe they stopped now, that it was caused by American soldiers. That can't happen. It's not going to happen. Not as long as I'm president. It comes from China.
Ooh, she got a little quiet there when faced with the fact that she's trying to carry the water of the Chinese propaganda.
Comes from China.
Can I go through how many erroneous things happen in all those clips?
Yeah,
one,
it's gonna be
the orchestra had no Asians in it. Bad orchestra.
True. Bad orchestra.
Two,
can't possibly be good.
We do call things by where they're coming from. That's how you distinguish them.
Yep.
It's a very common thing. It's not racist. Yep. Three, since when was being Chinese a race?
Wait, what?
Chinese is not a race. China is a nationality.
It's a nationality.
There's all types of races. In fact, there are all kinds of people of all kinds of different nationalities that live in China, that live in Wuhan.
Look like a racist character? When
I don't even know.
There's all kinds of people.
This jacket's a little small and my arms are close together.
I don't know.
I do get sweaty.
Super racist Chinese.
Can you even tell? Can people tell? Hold on, I ask this question. When I get suspicious, I squint my eyes, but
they're
already squinted. Can people tell when I'm suspicious?
Invert your eyelid
like flip up.
I don't know. But hey, now you've disrupted my all of those valid points. We'll get to most of them, and I want to lay out the case as to why there's a lot of blame at the foot of the Chinese government, not the people. I feel horrible for the people that they've been oppressed for so long. We'll get to that. Here's something interesting, though. Up until this point, the media had no problem using the term Wuhan virus.
The total number of deaths from the Wuhan coronavirus, it's now surpassed the SARS outbreak from 2002-2003.
It's a gay liberal from West Village.
Spreading fast as the number of confirmed cases of the Wuhan virus continue to surge.
The 34-year-old ophthalmologist diagnosed Saturday with the Wuhan coronavirus.
We have new information about how the Wuhan coronavirus is spread.
Good to have you with us. So we start with the Wuhan coronavirus spreading across China.
Wuhan, a coronavirus, have now been confirmed in all Chinese regions.
That was actually a pretty racist cartoon.
Anti-Chinese cartoon.
Worrisome. There are now 11 confirmed cases of the Wuhan coronavirus.
And so you wonder why earlier on this program we said it could get worse. Maybe not. We don't know yet. As well as we should point out where it actually stems from. Well, that's because of you. Lest you forget, for the purpose of consistency, I don't want to say it could get bad. At some point, okay, so I don't want you to go back here and say you said it would never get bad. It could get bad. If we're going to be naming the virus based on its source, wouldn't communist asshole virus be more apt? I mean, it did come from China. It has nothing to do with President Donald Trump. I'm the hipster of Wuhan virus.
Yeah. You are.
Head of the curve.
Look at you. Just trying to be more accurate.
And you know, and just like you said, we do this all the time. There are other diseases that are geographically named. We have a Spanish flu, West Nile. People don't know. Ebola, Zika, Lyme disease, German measles, not to mention the ill-named Polynesian island of Lou Gehrig. We know that all of these places.
Great oceans, blue seas.
By the way, is there anybody that actually
the county of AIDS.
That's a horrible name for a county. Is there anybody out there who actually thinks that Donald Trump was saying that all Chinese people are responsible for this? That's the worst premise I've ever seen for this argument.
Well, and this is what's so concerning to me is you have to wonder, is it disingenuous? Or are they really trying to use this simply as a tool for scoring political points? And here's something important. Now the Chinese government, they started shifting the blame, trying to say that they did a great job containing the virus and that maybe it didn't even come from Wuhan.
Donald Trump don't trust China. China is asshole.
That should be official policy.
Yeah, it really is.
We should have that in a chart.
Put that on the House
floor. So who decides to echo this? Bloomberg News. They ran pieces praising China's handling of the outbreak. The New York Times ran a piece claiming that China bought us time and that we were the ones who squandered it. The Washington Post. They reported that Trump was, quote, stoking nationalism by emphasizing the country where the virus originated, calling it the Wuhan virus, lodging conspiracy theories about it being deliberately weaponized and accusing the Chinese of a cover-up. But it did originate in Wuhan. And there was a cover-up. And China did not buy us time. They did the opposite of that. So this isn't just the blame game here where you're trying to say it's their fault. It matters because we need to understand how to deal with this in the future. And that doesn't just mean saying, hey, the CDC needs to do their part. We need to hold the media accountable. So let's assume, and I think rightfully so, that China is not to blame for creating the virus. They are certainly to blame for covering up and misleading the world.
Yes.
Several whistleblowers tried to raise awareness about this early on in December. Yeah. One of them was Dr. Am I pronouncing this right? Dr. Li Wenliang.
Yep, that's pretty good.
Wow. Oh, wow. Good
Very
for
nice.
Me.
Nice.
Good
job. Yeah.
See? Pandemics bringing us together. So what did the Chinese government, what did the media do? They forced him to recant under threat. They made him sign a document saying that his behavior was illegal, smeared him in the media, isolated him in conditions that ultimately led to, unfortunately, the man dying of the virus.
Well, a man who's become incredibly well known around the world because of the coronavirus has died. This is the Chinese doctor who tried to warn the medical community about the coronavirus. He was told to be quiet by the authorities before weeks later being diagnosed with the virus himself.
Frank, I don't think that newscaster would know.
Do you think is being quiet just a euphemism for like spiked bat to the face?
I mean, it could be.
Since when have we decided that a nation who's had its entire history based on human rights violations is the paragon of truth how people are suffering or not suffering?
So the left, here's the thing too that's important. The left in the United States now, they've been they were celebrating these whistleblowers, by the way, when they thought it was just a story about a foreign virus in some distant land in China. All of a sudden, once it arrived on American shores, everything changed. They started praising China and its handling instead of highlighting its gross incompetence. And by the way, simultaneously right now, they're placing the blame squarely at the feet of President Trump. And this is not, we want to be clear, this wasn't just an isolated incident, a few whistleblowers being silenced. Okay? Some more. Just this week, we learned there was a Wuhan. Is it Wuhan or Wuhan?
Wuhan.
Wuhan. Wuhan. I was saying it right, and then I said it wrong because they were saying Wuhan.
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 So just this week, we learned that Wuhan, there was a Wuhan lab that identified the coronavirus in December. It was ordered to stop testing and destroy the samples.
Wow.
China is now trying to censor the story. China is now even banning, if you need a synonym, Western journalists who've reported on their incompetence, which is, again, why we say,
Donald Trump don't trust China. China is asshole.
A little flowery. I think he could be quicker, straight to the point. And by the way, while we're talking about media, please do hit the notification bell. Hit all notifications if you're watching this on YouTube, because subscriptions don't mean a whole lot these days. And do consider joining Mug Club. That's the only thing that allows us to continue creating this kind of content, not beholden to Al Jazeera or a foreign caliphate. Yeah. And new videos every day, 9 p.m. Eastern. Here's another point that really matters. Not only about the cover-up, China could have prevented this.
Yeah.
It's not just about the blame game. It's, again, it's about the opportunity cost, and ultimately that's people's lives. If China had not covered it up, and I mean the Chinese government, the Chinese people are just as much a victim of the Chinese government as anybody else, meaning the entire world. That's what the pandemic means, as far as I understand it. It could have been prevented. So here's some recent reports that actually show China had its first confirmed cases of coronavirus as early as November. Okay? And then there was a recent study that showed that if China had enacted measures after the whistleblower's warning, rather than hitting with a 2x4 and a nail through it, they could have prevented 95% of the virus cases.
Wow.
But they didn't. They stopped testing. They destroyed the results. They silenced whistleblowers. They even refused help that was offered to them by the World Health Authority and the CDC. The CDC was not allowed in, and so it became a global pandemic.
Donald Trump don't trust China. China is asshole.
Little trigger happy. We get it. Yeah, but keep it coming. It's better. It's better for me to scale you back than ask you to come in with me.
It's no less true on the seventh time than the first.
It's no less true. But here's the thing. Where's the digging? If we're talking about Donald Trump, we want to blame him for the CDC. Again, tomorrow I'm going to have my Dr. Choi on the show, who's actually a certified practitioner who's had to deal with this. He's my personal doctor, and he's Asian. He's a Korean, so it'll be an interesting perspective. But while we're blaming Donald Trump for this, media, where's the digging when we're talking about China? Whistleblowers, that stuff gives you a raging erection most of the time.
Yeah.
Where's the Aaron Brockovich scenario?
Oh, man.
It's undeniable. 95% of this could have been prevented had China just not only not lied, but not physically harmed the people who were trying to save the rest of the world.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean that the United States handled everything well, but we certainly know that it was handled with malice and ill intent over there with the Chinese government. And I don't know. What happened? Yeah. What happened with China? Here's where we are right now. And it breaks your heart. Communist fascist regime gonna communist fascist regime. They start sending in police, forcibly throwing people into quarantine now against their will. That's where they are.
That's terrifying.
It really is. They know if you go to the hospital, you don't come back.
And this is why I like the fact that America is a melting pot, because you toss one Obama phone lady in there, it's a very different scenario.
Yeah,
I'm not going
fists
in here.
Are flying.
Oh, y'all motherfuckers are crazy. I'm being taken. These people are just going with it. And I understand. This is why, like you talked about, you said the expression in China is, what is it, the nail
that sticks up gets hammered down.
Right.
Yeah.
And these people live in fear. And so American journalists, guess what? You are enabling the oppression of Chinese people by doing this. They can't stand up for it. Instead, you're too busy blaming Trump. If this is not an absolute disaster and pandemic, it will be, while we're talking about them politicizing it, which is unfortunately what they've already done, it will be a disaster for Democrats. It will be a disaster for the left. Unless this becomes an extremely fatal, uncontrollable scenario.
Yes.
Since that's what they've predicted and they've tried to pin that on Trump, it will be bad for them. That's horrible. They have a vested interest in that being the case. Again, just talking about people acting in their own self-interest. Let's assume that Donald Trump is acting exclusively in his self-interest and he doesn't care about the American people. I don't, but let's assume that. And let's assume that Wolf Blitzer is doing the same. One says, read my lips, this is going to be a disaster, the kind of which you've never seen. We're going to see fatalities, the kinds of which you've never experienced, and this is why the media's job is so important. And then you have President Donald Trump saying, we're doing everything that we can, take these proper precautions, we're going to get it under control. These people have a vested interest in being held to their word. Just like if Democrats are the party of the poor, it's in their best interest to keep you poor. If Republicans are the party of the rich, they need a 50% plus voting block.
It's helpful. Yeah.
And this is what really bothers me about this. There would be some serious value in having trust in the media right now and knowing where to turn and get accurate information. Yeah. But it's hard after the Russia hoax, the Covington kids, the Kavanaugh rape hoaxes, Jesse Smollett. The list goes on. You're the little boy who cried coronavirus. I guess you cried Donald Trump, and now you sort of cried it synonymously. I desperately wish that we could trust someone in the media right now. Wouldn't it be nice to know that they're telling the truth? But this is why Americans don't trust you, because you immediately tied it with President Donald Trump. You complain about us being politically divided in this country. I mean, I understand, and that's a problem. In some facets and other facets, I think it's a good thing so that we know where we line up. But in a time like this, we should be coming together to try and keep the most vulnerable among us protected. You complain about us being divided, and then you immediately start using Chinese government communist propaganda talking points to attack our commander-in-chief amidst, according to your own definition, a pandemic. Who has the Americans' best interests at heart? The worst thing you can do right now is try and weaponize this politically, and I'm not saying that for Donald Trump. I'm saying that for the American public and ultimately for trust in our institutions. You're shooting yourself in the foot. So we don't know what's going to happen, not making predictions, but my God, I hope that at least some folks here who are in control of information stop siding with a f***ing communist Chinese propagandist government. Guess who I am? I'm Josh Hartnett. Bet you didn't think you'd see that face in a while. This is what we call an end card, which is where I tell you that you should subscribe if you like this video or click one of these other videos that you may like. Hit the notification bell, of course, join Mug Club, because that's what allows us to continue doing these videos. And just so you know, YouTube actually has created a new policy where they might start outright banning channels that are no longer commercially viable, which means that this is merely a figment of your imagination.